What's up guys, Sal here. So as you already know, the Pixel 6 will debut Google's long-rumored custom smartphone silicon. In other words, the Pixel 6 appears set to ditch Qualcomm's Snapdragon brand for something built in-house with the help of Samsung's SLSI division. As you know, Google already makes one of the best cameras you can get in a smartphone, and recently it has begun siphoning features from Android to give the Pixel a degree of exclusivity. So by controlling the processor, hardware, and OS, Google could create one of the best phones to run Android. An in-house chip would give the iPhone its first true competitor that controls the whole stack. Yeah, Samsung does that too, but partially because in the US they don't use their in-house Exynos chips. Anyway, there are definitely some intriguing possibilities for a Google-led mobile application processor. However, they are not just limited to speed and efficiency. It's more than that, and let me explain some of the bigger possibilities. The biggest change could be to updates. As it stands, Google only promises 3 years of Android version and security updates. Samsung does the same, 3 major OS updates, but offers 4 years of security updates. And while Apple doesn't technically guarantee a length of time you'll receive iOS updates when you purchase an iPhone, every model since the iPhone 4 has gotten at least 5 years of updates. With a custom chip, buying a Google phone should carry the same guarantee as an iPhone, basically that you'll get updates as long as you own your phone. Android updates go a lot smoother when you get support from the SoC manufacturer, but Qualcomm abandons all its chips after the 3-year mark for major updates. This lack of support makes updates significantly harder than they need to be. So by controlling the guts and the OS, the Pixel phone should be a gold standard for Android phone updates and eliminate one of the major reasons to buy an iPhone. Next, an SoC division would give Google some much-needed flexibility when it comes to hardware. I mean, the most successful in-house SoC division is easily Apple's, which regularly produces chips that wipe the floor with Qualcomm smartphone and smartwatch SoCs. Apple's SoC division lets it produce chips for whatever hardware form factor it wants. The Apple Watch owes its entire existence to Apple's fast and battery-efficient S SoCs. AirPods run on the Edge SoC and can pick up whatever features Apple wants. Apple can choose its own destiny instead of assembling puzzle pieces from other vendors. But right now, Google doesn't have that flexibility. For example, Android doesn't have a proper off-the-shelf smartphone chip for a while now. Yes, Samsung makes their own smartwatch chips, but they don't sell them to others. Qualcomm has an SoC monopoly, but has decided to basically ignore the smartwatch market. So for years, there have been no modern options for a smartwatch chip, and that's the reason there hasn't been a good Wear OS smartwatches for a while now. This isn't just about smartwatches either. If Google wants to build any kind of new form factor wearable, it needs to get Qualcomm on board first. Right now, if Qualcomm says no, like it did for smartwatches, the market ceases to exist. But that could change if Google controls the chip division, and we are already seeing the results of that. Google is working on their first Pixel watch, and the renders of it have already been leaked, which shows that Google is making one of the most beautiful smartwatches around that will launch alongside the Pixel 6 in October later this year. And not just smartphones and smartwatches, the Google Silicon could power the Chromebooks as well, similar to Apple. Google could create a similar system to the Mac and iPhone, with apps that run well on both systems, services that seamlessly sync, and more. Of course, none of this as simple as popping a new chip into the next Pixel phone, but if Google is ready to make this change now, there could be many more to come, and with it, many more surprises. Let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.